name is Carla Verdesoto, and today I will be showing you the next steps in preparing your plate for firing and skin. The plate has been sitting on the hot plate for a while, and now I will turn it off and let it cool. Allow your plate to cool before moving it, because a severe temperature change will cause your plate to crack. Once your plate has cooled, you will need to put it in a kiln for firing. This process will turn the metal nitrates into metal oxides. In our lab, this is the kiln we use. Your plates will need to be fired for 2 hours at 500 degrees Celsius. Depending on your school, you may use a ceramics kiln or a hot plate outfitted with an insulating cover and a thermocouple. It is very important for you to maintain a temperature at 500 degrees Celsius, because below this temperature the nitrates will not turn into oxides, and above this temperature you will ruin the conductivity of your plate. The same principles apply for removing your plate from a kiln as they do from removing it from a hot plate. Allow the kiln to cool to room temperature before removing the plate to prevent it from shattering. To prepare the plate for scanning, you will first need to cut a 3 to 4 inch piece of wire. You will then need to strip both ends of the wire. Now that both ends have been stripped, you will need to connect it to the plate. You will need to use a conductive paint such as the silver conductive epoxy. Check our attached sheet on the website that will show the other possibilities of alternate attachment. To make the paste, you will need to mix equal parts epoxy A and B. This very little is needed because I will only be using a small amount to connect the wire to the plate. Lay the wire flat onto the plate on the conductive side and coat the exposed wire with a silver epoxy.
You can either let this air dry while you perform other tasks, or you can speed up the process by heating it on a hot plate. You will then need to coat the silver epoxy with an insulating layer, such as clear 5-minute epoxy. Clear 5-minute epoxy is similar to the silver epoxy. It comes in two tubes that are already connected to get equal amounts. You will then need to stir to mix them same as the silver epoxy. You will then need to completely cover silver epoxy.
Make sure to completely cover the silver epoxy.
This is the finished product, and you are now ready to perform a scan.